sequel, The Evil Dead 2, Mr. Sam Raimi.
When The Evil Dead was released in 1982, it attracted rave reviews. Stephen King called it the most ferociously original horror film of the year. Yet the film had initially been turned down by every American distributor who had seen it. The Evil Dead was an independent production, financed by a group of doctors, lawyers, and dentists from America's Midwest, and it marked the feature film debut of writer and director Sam Raimi, who remarkably was only 19 at the time.
There are two schools of thought, I think, for horror filmmakers. One is that the audience can always create something more horrible than you can show them. And the other school of thought is show them everything. And I believe that both is true. I believe the audience can come up with something more horrible in their minds than I can show them, provided they're given the raw materials to construct something. And I also believe that I've got some pretty horrible things to show myself, so I try and mix and match, try and scare them and weird them out with visuals, and I try to leave room for them to add their own ingredients to create.
Although this was his first feature, Sam had already directed a handful of Super 8 movies, which had given him the chance to develop a distinctive and confident style.
Started in filmmaking in the first place. What kind of movies were you making before The Evil Dead?
Before The Evil Dead, my friends and myself, just a group of school chums, and I would make Super 8 comedies, Three Stooges comedies.
There was a nucleus of about six of us who had this interest, and we all were split apart in different neighborhoods. We had a little neighborhood here, and Sam was over in his little neighborhood making Super 8 movies. Sam did a lot of magic, and so film seemed like a natural extension for him to do that. So he was doing these silly little movies, and I was doing silly little movies. And another guy, Scott Spiegel, who co-wrote Evil Dead 2, was making like Three Stooges ripoffs, where he'd use the actual soundtrack but put in his own visuals. And then we kind of all hooked up in high school, and then we found that, you know, one guy had costumes and another guy had a good camera. So we combined all of our facilities, and then we were able to, on weekends, we just would go out and shoot.
Bruce Campbell starred in every Super 8 movie that we made because, very simply, he was the good-looking one and still is. So we said, the girls like you, we'll put you in front of the camera. The girls don't like us, we'll stay behind the camera. And only when Bruce was unavailable would we put ourselves in front of the camera.
You showed some raw acting ability in those. Why didn't you stay in front more? Why did you stay?
I don't think I showed any acting ability, and I stick my face in any movie that I can, truthfully, shamelessly, to get my mug on the screen.
Why did you think Stooges had such an influence on you? What do you like about them?
I like their physical comedy and their sound effects. You know, the hyper-real shticks that they do, and they just make me laugh. They just make me laugh, and I make big audiences laugh in the theaters.
Tell us about 6 months to Live. That's not a Three Stooges.
It's Three Stooge like, and certainly we've ripped off, stolen blatantly as 16-year-olds, many Three Stooges gags, and did them ourselves. So it was greatly influenced by the Three Stooges.
So where would you show these films? In classrooms and at home?
Yes, exactly. To the other students.
Would you charge money?
Sure. As much as we could get. Usually a quarter.
Sam and I first decided to do a horror film after doing research on what pictures did well in the markets. And at the time, which was the late 70s, there were still a lot of drive-ins, especially in the Midwest where we grew up. And there were forever horror films playing in the drive-ins on double bills and that, which we always saw and said, God, we can make something better than this. There's absolutely no doubt about it. So up until the time we decided to make a feature film, we had done mainly comedies and decided that horror is the entry level that most people use, and decided to make the ultimate experience in horror at the time.
Robert Tappert, Bruce Campbell, and myself all bought business suits and matching briefcases and dropped out of school. Then we worked in greater